Well, Athens, London, Rio, Beijing, they are some of the world's greatest cities, and they're also Olympic cities. And when representatives from the Olympic cities meet every year, another city is at the table, St. Louis. And tonight's Practice to Podium segment, St. Louis's Olympic legacy. With these rings, we turn back the pages of time.
One of the most distinctive moments in the history of St. Louis.
Permanently displayed on the campus of Washington University, the Olympic rings represent our region's Olympic legacy.
There's a saying in the Olympic world, once an Olympic city, always an Olympic city.
1904 may be best known around here as the year of the World's Fair, but it was also the year of the third modern-day Olympics and the first on American soil.
And it was the best way to show the United States what the Olympics were. People didn't really know.
Mike Lloyd is the chairman of the St. Louis Sports Commission's Olympic Legacy Committee. And he says the 1904 Games were home to many important firsts.
It was the first time we ever had a decathlon. It was in St. Louis. The first diving was in St. Louis. The first swimming relay was in St. Louis.
And the first modern-day Olympic stadium was built, Francis Olympic Field, which is still in use today. 1904 was also the year that George Pogue competed.
He was the son of slaves, and he was the first African-American Olympian to medal.
And long before Michael Phelps, there was Charles Daniels.
So he was an Olympic swimmer. He won 5 medals here, and he invented the freestyle stroke.
And speaking of medals, the St. Louis Games were the first to give out gold, silver, and bronze medals for first, second, and third place, something the Amateur Athletic Union was doing.
So when it came to St. Louis, they adopted that, and it stayed with the Olympics ever since.
Though it was long ago, St. Louis can wear the 1904 Games like a badge of honor. Every year, the Sports Commission is invited to a meeting of the World Union of Olympic Cities, along with Athens, Beijing, London, and the rest, to promote the spirit of the Games.
And it's not all the time that St. Louis can be at that table with an array of cities like that.
1904 venues at Creve Coeur Lake, to Glen Echo Country Club, to Washington University, are a reminder of our contribution to the essence of the Olympics, that when we all come together, we can achieve great things.
If you had 2 cars in your garage and one of them was a 1904 Model T and the other one was a 2021 Lexus, you wouldn't say the old car was a piece of junk. It's a piece of history.
Francis Olympic Field, by the way, is on the campus of Washington University and is still used by the university's football, soccer, and track and field teams. So the first Olympic gold medal was handed out here in St. Louis. The first modern-day Olympiad was at Athens, and they handed out flowers. And the second was in Paris, and they handed out bowls. But the medals started right here.
Very cool. Another first at the 1904 Olympics.
Exactly.
The waffle cone.
That's right.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
That's very important.
That is very important.